Hello, my name is Carly McAvoy, and today we're doing graphing inequalities. And what does y is greater than 4 mean, and how could we draw a picture of it? Well, what it actually means is that our number y, whichever number it is, could be any number as long as our number is greater than 4. So it could be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1,000, 10,000, 4 million, anything that's bigger than 4. In fact, it doesn't have to be an integer or a whole number. It could be a rational number like 4.2, 5.69, 7.5, anything that's greater than 4. So how could we show that? Because we certainly can't list them all out, and we do it with a picture, and we do it on a number line. So all I want you to do when you're doing these on paper is to put the number that you're dealing with on your graph. In this case, we're dealing with 4. And since we're dealing with 4, we're going to give it a coordinate system. We'll talk about y, but I'm going to leave an open circle there. And then y is anything, because y isn't exactly 4. There's no equal to part there. So when you put an open circle, that means that we're not including 4, but it's a good starting point. And then we're going to go to the right. You don't have to shade a whole way, but enough to show that's it. It's anything from 4 or to the right on the number line 4 or greater. What's the difference between greater than and greater than equal to? Well, we just had a greater than, which the difference between that and the greater than equal to is that 4 is not part of the solution. It's a starting point, but it's not part of the solution. When you use the greater than symbol, the two quantities that you are comparing cannot be equal. But when you use the greater than equal to symbol, the quantities could be equal. When graphing, we show the difference between the two by using O, which is an open circle, and O colored in, which is a closed circle. If you have greater than or less than, you use an open circle. If you have greater than equal to or less than equal to, then you used a closed or a shaded circle. Notice that when we have no equal to part, there's less to our circle and there's less to our symbols. We don't bother to shade it. When there's more to our symbols, there's more to our thing. That is, we add the shading. That's a good way to remember it. So let's look at a graph of some inequalities. These have different symbols, greater than equal to, less than equal to, but the basic idea for graphing is going to be the same. I'm going to draw a line, and I'm going to put the number on it that I'm dealing with. That is the 5. Then I decide, do I have an open circle or a closed circle? Well, it's got the equal to part. So we're not only saying 5 is a starting point, but it's also part of the solution. So it's a shaded circle. It should be obviously shaded, not like what I just left half open. Now we're asking, are we shading to the left or the right? If you keep your variable on the left side, your arrow will point the direction you need to shade. X is greater than, and greater than goes to the right, so it looks like that. What about y is less than negative 3? Well, the number that we are dealing with is negative 3. Then you ask yourself, should I have an open circle or a closed circle? Negative 3 is definitely our starting point, but could y be equal to that? No, so we don't want to shade it. If you have no equal to part, you have no shading. Then it says y is less than that number. Numbers that are less are left. So less is left. We're going to shade to the left, and notice that our arrow points to the left. All right. P is less than or equal to 1/2. It doesn't matter if you have a fraction or a decimal or whatever you have. You're just going to put your number right here, and that is 1/2. I don't need you to draw 0 and show me the relationship and all that. Just the number is fine. Okay. So then I say, I know that 1 is a half is a starting point. But could P be equal to that? Well, yes, it could. It's got the equal to part. So then I shade it, and P is less than 1/2, and less is left, or left is less, whichever one you want to say first, but it's shading to the left. Notice that less than or equal to, both shade to the left. One of them, though, has an open circle and one has a closed. You should try these on your own to see how you're doing on these and then come back and check in. In this one, Q is greater than 17. 17 is my number. It's definitely a starting point. Is it also possible for Q to be equal to that? Answer, no. There's no equal to part, so we don't shade. And it's greater than, so we shade to the right. When you solve inequalities, you solve and then you graph. And that's why we had to practice this. Okay, what about this one? I've got the Y on the other side. These are harder to do. We definitely have negative 3 as a starting place. So, is it possible for it to be equal? No, because there's no equal to part. But be careful here, because it's nice when the Y is on the left side. When it's on the left side, the X, the Y, or the P, or whatever, it's very easy because the arrow points the direction you're going to shade. When it's on the right side, it's the opposite, so it gets more confusing. But what this is saying is Y is greater than negative 3, because it's open to the Y is the greater value. And since it's greater than negative 3, greater than shades to the right. You could flip-flop this around, and if you did, see how this is pointing at negative 3? It has to point at negative 3 down here, and so you can see, oh yeah, it's greater than when you write it that way. So what's happening here? You have the number 8. That is your starting point. Should I shade the circle? Well, I have an equal to part, so yes, I add additional piece. And it says 8 is greater than M, but I'm interested in what is M. And if I flip it around, do you see how the arrow was pointing at M? When I flip it around, it still has to point to the same thing. I can't just go, oh, well, now I'm going to make it point to the 8. It didn't point to the 8, it points to the M. M then is less than or equal to, less than goes to the left. And remember, if it's on the right, the arrow points in the opposite direction of how you want to shade. So what I might suggest is that you make all your inequalities have your letter on the left side, and it makes it easier to graph. All right, we'll see you next time. Have a fantastic day.